Thank you for joining, everyone. Welcome to Programmers Week 2020. So before we get started, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all the members who have joined the session. So if you have already attended the session in Programmers Week 2020, I hope you guys had a very nice experience attending Programmers Week 2020. So we had a huge lineup of very technical sessions till now. So I hope you enjoyed that. And in this next 45 minutes, what we are going to discuss is SAP testing using Tricentis Tosca. So both are currently the big names in the particular industry, SAP as well as Tricentis. So we are going to discuss few aspects in those particular topics in the next 45 minutes. So before we get started and get into this particular topic, let me introduce myself. I'm Arjun. I'm a QA professional with 6 years of IT experience in an agile testing environment. So I am an automation enthusiast, and I worked with open source as well as paid tools, as you call it, which are the industrial leaders like UFT, Tosca, SmartBeer Test Complete, and so on. So that is a quick brief. So currently I'm working with Cognizant Software Fusion for the past 2 years, and let's get into the session. Rasina, can we move to the next slide? Okay, so before we get into the topic, the first question which comes to our mind is, if a person is new to this particular topic, is what is SAP? So it is a ERP. It is an enterprise resource planning system, which helps in maintaining data for various business functions. So the business functions can be manufacturing, supply chain management, finance, HR, customer relationship. Whatever you call it, there is a particular system or application which SAP supports. So when it comes to for example, if you take projects, it can be a system for maintaining your project billings. It can be a system for managing your leave balances, your cost billing timesheet. Okay, there is will be a particular system provided by SAP for doing that particular aspect. If it comes to supply chain management, there can be a system for placing the order, doing the external billing, creating the particular reports. So all the particular aspects, whatever you think about in a particular business, there will be a system provided by SAP for realizing that particular function. Okay. So in if you think about it, or if you I couldn't fathom that if I take maybe 2,000 clients or 2,000 technical companies. Can you guys guess how many will be using SAP? Well, just a question for your pondering. But can we go to the next slide? So out of 2,000 companies, 1,800 plus runs SAP systems. And out of this 1,800, if you take, 95% of them think that automated testing and impact analysis would make their life significantly easier. So that is a very bold statement, which most of the technical savvy companies have put forth. And the huge customer base of SAP you can think about. If you think like out of 2,000 technologically well-driven companies, out of them 1,800 plus runs SAP systems. So that is a very huge number. And if you think about the QA aspects coming into picture, if you think about even if you take 500 of those particular clients, the impact, if you automate or if you can reduce the overhead of these particular companies, the impact is going to be huge. Okay. On that particular note, let's get into more aspects. What are the QA aspects coming into picture when we talk about SAP system and others? Yeah, can we move to that? Yes. So SAP comes in many flavors. Okay. So few of the terms you have been hearing very recently. If you are following a lot of technical techno magazines or different articles given by technological vendors, some terms might ring a bell, like SAP HANA, Fiori, S4 HANA migration. These might be few terms which might be running through your mind. But then before all this, there was an older version of SAP systems which were running everything. It corresponds to our transaction details, our creation of orders, whatever it may be. There might be a SAP system which is running. If you see the first image, that is a SAP GUI interface, which most of you might have been using. If you had to interact with any of the SAP servers, you have to connect to a SAP server and perform some transactions. SAP GUI interface might be the first thing which you might have used. The RP integration is something which was there in place as an integration system. So if you need to communicate between two or three systems which are available, R3 integration solutions was the go-to part till now. Again, SAP ABAP, that might be something which might ring a bell, that term called as ABAP. That is again a programming, object programming methodology for creation of modules within SAP. Okay, so all these particular aspects comes into picture. And now, as any most of the IT companies are trying for a digital transformation and other things. So the same thing has triggered few newer products which respond faster, perform faster with respect to SAP as well. Okay. So when you look at the landscape of the IT industry right now, most of the companies might have already invested a lot of amount in setting up the particular SAP system, setting up the infra for this, and so on. Okay. So one thing which comes to the mind when we talk about the old SAP systems is their business model as well. That is something which we need to talk about if we need to understand what we are going to talk in this particular session, or like why the new changes are coming up. Okay. So what used to happen earlier was SAP will license a particular product. The backend part, the database component, the person who is buying the license, they can set up their own data. Maybe the vendor might be Microsoft, Oracle, or any other database provider. So what used to happen was the software will be from SAP. The database component can be from a third party, okay, which is being managed by the person who is procuring the license. Now, so if you can think about this, the license cost is there, the infra cost is there, and the performance is solely dependent upon how the database component performs. Okay, so all those particular aspects may hinder the performance of the SAP systems which you are using. Okay, so any system which you use, it can be any kind of UI. It will be always, we need to ensure that it is working properly, the functional aspects. Any changes we make to, any of the particular components, okay, we'll need to perform some sort of analysis to ensure like whatever changes I am making, it does not impact that particular system. And I need to ensure the system performs. Okay, this is kind of like the sanity criteria when we talk about any of the particular software. It may be any sort of mobile apps, it can be any sort of web app, anything of that stuff. These are the three criteria which any QA professional might be thinking about. Okay, so let's see the challenges which are there in place when we talk about the SAP old system which are in, which is being implemented in most of the companies. Okay, so the cost of testing, it can account for more than 70% of the project value. Okay, this is because of the following. So usually what used to happen for SAP systems is they used to follow something called as a ASAP method. Okay, so there will be a project preparation. Then there will be a business blueprint which is in place, which ensures that this is the business flow which needs to happen and other things. And once that is done, the realization, that is the implementation aspect, and then the project go live, and then the production related validations, all those things used to happen. Okay. And again, this used to happen in three phases. First, all the implementation will be done in the dev environment. Then everything will be moved to the QA environment. Once everything is done there, then everything, I mean, the same system gets transferred to the fraud environment and so on. Okay. So everything used to happen in phases. Now, the issue is, in this particular traditional approach, we are expecting all the systems to be available all the time. For example, if I am testing a component called as B and it has dependency on B and C, I am expecting B and C to be available without any bugs, at every point of time. Okay. Anyone who has been with the IT industry can understand that that is never going to happen. If there are three components A, B, and C dependent on one another, hell is going to break loose when we are integrating and testing it. Okay, that is kind of like a generic rule which is there in the IT industry. If you look at any of the QA processes, right? So, and another thing is because there are so many interdependent systems and so many departments who are going to work on this. So like maybe finance, procurement, or maybe HR team who is taking care of the time sheets, billability, and all those particular aspects. All these particular teams work on their own individual silos. Okay. And there will be, say, for example, if you're talking about the old SAP system, it had the R3 integration. Okay. So any change which is being done in the R3 integration aspect, it will impact all the particular components. Okay. So any small change which we might think that it does not impact a particular module might have unprecedented impact if it is not properly tested for all the particular components. So if you start thinking about it, a person who is working on module A will have business knowledge with respect to module A only. B will have its own business process related functions, and C will have its own functions and so on. So when it comes to testing any of this particular components, the business knowledge which is required to create the use cases or anything else is maintained in these particular silos. So there is a huge dependency on the business users when the traditional approach is being followed. Okay, and then again the releases were maybe happening once a year or once every 3 years or 2 years kind of thing, or maybe twice a year. Okay, so the update cycle as well as the release cycle, whichever was required, was very less. Okay, so in between these particular release or test cycles, whoever had acquired the knowledge for testing that particular process, he might be moving out of the organization, or a new person might have come into the department. Okay, so there might be lot of possibilities which can go wrong. Okay, this is with respect to the old SAP systems and the testing challenges which you might face when you are testing the old SAP system. Okay, can we go to the next slide? Yeah. So why modernize SAP ecosystem when the old one is still working, or is working perfectly as expected? That is because SAP has given a mandate to everyone to migrate to S4 by 2025. And before this particular session, I just read the article which said the date has been extended till 2030. Okay, just right before the session, I just saw a notification which said that the deadline has been extended till 2030. Okay, so what does this mean? So previously, as I talked about, SAP systems were you can buy the license and the DB component can be given to a third party. Okay, SAP is stopping that. So it has revoked its agreement with almost all the vendors, and they are trying to promote their HANA, that is an in-memory relation RDBMS system developed by SAP. So what is happening here is SAP has its own protocol through which it will be communicating with all this particular system. Okay. So what SAP is trying to do is, it is trying to ensure that the transactions and all those particular process related information will be happening faster, and it is not dependent on any other vendor. Okay. So it has control over its own components, how the performance is, and other things. Okay, so when we talk about HANA, and if you compare it with the third party system, the statistics which they have given us, it is 10 times faster. So if you are trying to perform a particular transaction, on an SAP system, which is having HANA as a database and maybe a third party system, the statistics they have conveyed is it is 10 times faster. Okay. And again, we are trying to move away from the waterfall model and we are trying to push for the agile process everywhere. And the digital transformation is the core component for almost all the organizations. Okay. So this is a way, or this has been a trigger for that particular transformation journey. Again, SAP is available in cloud environment as well, so that you don't have to maintain your own infrastructure. You don't have to maintain, you don't need to have a specialist for maintaining your infrastructure, maintenance, and other things. Okay, SAP workload can be migrated to cloud. So almost all, in platform as a service, infrastructure as a service, software as a service, right? That all these particular factors coming in has triggered the transformation of SAP ecosystem as well. Okay. And again, obviously the business process transformation. Now everything is faster. I was talking to my dad a few weeks back. So he was mentioning about how the stocks were getting purchased some time back. So he had to go into a particular bank, he had to fill in forms, and he had to attach a check, and then submit the particular form. Return form so that he can buy stock. Okay. So, if I think about it now, I don't think it will be practical for me, at least. So for us, it will be like, an app is available, you create an account, you get all your, digital KYC done, and you have 4 hours and you are done, and you can get started. You can add funds, through debit card, credit card, checks, UPI payment interface if you are in India or something. And you can get started, on the same day. Okay. So the business transformation is happening in multiple fronts. Okay. So it can be anything. So whichever KYC, know your customer verification used to happen, maybe manually, it can be done through if you are in India, it can be done right now through Aadhaar based OTP verification. So the entire business process in that particular aspect is changing. Okay. So all those particular factors coming in is triggering the SAP ecosystem change as well. Can you go to the next slide? Okay. So now what is new? Okay. S/4HANA is coming. SAP Theory UX. Then with respect to the cloud infrastructure part, on-premise, hybrid, and cloud. Okay. All those particular flavors are coming in. Okay. So one question which might pop up in your mind is S/4HANA and HANA. What is the difference? So HANA is like the, in-memory DB, which SAP is developing. S/4HANA is like the application which will only work with HANA. Okay. So S/4HANA is the application which has been developed using their UI interfaces, the UI interfaces, which will only work if you have HANA as the DB part. Okay. So the response will be faster. It is available in your mobile and it can be integrated with almost all the native hybrid apps like Ariba, Conquer for your expense management, Ariba for your procurement. Okay. Then maybe for vendor management, they have something called a field glass nowadays. Okay. So all those particular things can be integrated. It can be, you can access those particular applications in any device. Okay. So all those particular factors are coming up in the new SAP ecosystem. Okay. Can we go to the next slide? Okay. So what are the new testing challenges which we are having when it comes to the new SAP ecosystem? Obviously, the infrastructure is going to be complex. Okay. There are so many interdependent systems, or you need to maintain it in cloud. Okay. Or the communication needs to happen between all these particular systems. You need to ensure the data is in sync between all these particular systems. There is no if an issue happens in one of the systems, you need to ensure it doesn't impact other systems and so on. The next one is more frequent releases. If you think about any software release, even if it is a web app also, as the frequency of the releases increases, the chances of a bug popping up, you know, or getting leaked to the production environment obviously skyrocket, right? So with if you see the SAP releases, so it has become something like a release a month or a release every 2 months kind of thing. And as the company also has to keep up with these particular updates. And the major issue which all the companies are going to face is every company is going to have their own custom objects which they have to which they would have created. Okay, so the custom object can be based out of a feature which or a particular process which the company is running, which is not a regular thing which will be available for all the particular companies. So in those particular cases, there will be custom modules which each company would have implemented. They would have their own developers who will be creating its own objects or components in SAP system. And any change in the particular system, okay, they need to ensure that whatever custom modules, whatever they have created, works as is and it is not impacted. Or any change in the code based on these particular updates does not impact other integrated systems. Okay, again, overloaded business users, as the test cycle increases, be people who are aware of the particular business process. Okay, who can guide the QA team or who are part of the QA team. And again, the term which is popping up nowadays is a techno business analyst. So, just like, as DevOps is coming into picture, there is a blurry line between BA, the QA, as well as the ops team. Everyone are part of the same ops team and everyone is trying to ensure that their product is without bugs. And they just want to ensure that the quality of the product is high. No one can ensure 100% the quality of your product. Okay. So, but then what we can ensure is the high risk component, okay, which will have a huge impact on your business. We can ensure that it is properly tested. There is no integration issues happening when multiple systems are being integrated and so on. Okay. And again, version control. So as the number of releases increases, there might be some systems which are dependent on one version of SAP and so on. So there might be situations where you have to maintain different versions of the particular application. Maybe in the dev environment, you might be having another version. Maybe in the staging environment, which has been released, it might be having another another version of SAP system running. Okay, and so on. Okay. So there is, there will be challenges when you are trying to have this particular clear-cut distinction. Okay, if you are working with a web app, there might be, you might be creating a Docker container. You might be tagging it as maybe dev, QA, staging, then maybe gold or something, so that you can pull that particular image to prod and deploy. So all those particular aspects. We already have a clear mindset, like this is the thing that you need to do when you are trying to deploy a Docker, maybe through Docker, or something. So similar manner, there are challenges in maintaining your test suite as well. So there might be issues with there might be changes in the UI objects. So whatever might have worked in version one may become not interactable in version two. It might be due to some object property changes or anything else. So the challenge comes with respect to the technological aspects in test automation tools as well. Okay. So the technical obstacle, the main thing will be the project, the object property changes, maybe the resolution changes and other things. Okay. So the solution for that, which SAP has also come up with, is a strategic partnership with Tricenter. Okay. So the main three questions which we talked about earlier, what to test, does it work, and does it scale? Okay. So what to test is like, there is a change happening in my system. So what we usually do is we try to do an impact analysis. So this is a change happening, which are the modules which is getting affected. So we'll be analyzing that and we'll be ensuring that the test is touching all the particular components which is having this particular impact. Okay. But when it comes to an SAP system, the integration is so complex. Like, for example, it might be getting integrated with maybe 70, maybe hundreds or, you know, thousands of systems, and that too different vendors. So all the data might be coming up into a, you know, SAP DB finally. Okay. So there might be some integration buses and other things which is coming into picture. Okay. So these, all these particular factors, if you, you know, consider the main three questions which is going to pop up first: what to test, does my system work, and does it scale? Okay. Can we go to the next slide, please? So the answer to these particular questions from the Quisenbus SAP partnership is what to test. It can be analyzed and the solution can be given using the tool called as Quisenbus Live Compare. Okay. And does it work? The functional testing, I mean the functional aspects of the particular system. The solution which is intended as Quisenbus Tosca. And does it scale the performance of the particular system? And one of the solutions which is suggested is Quisenbus Flex. Okay. So what we are going to do in this particular discussion is we are going to talk about all these particular three components, but we will be concentrating more on the Tosca functional testing side. Okay. So what is Tosca? That is one question which might pop up to your mind. Okay. So Tosca is a continuous testing platform which makes use of model-based testing or MVT and based testing, RBT, to reduce number of test cases which you will have to, you know, execute or create, and it will ensure that you have the maximum coverage in less amount of time. Okay, so now on your right hand side, you can see a set of an image which says, okay, which are the features which is being provided by Quisenbus. Okay, so closed browser testing for mobile, for load testing, exploratory testing, test management. So for test management, they have their own solution called as Q-Test. Okay. Then test data management, they have their own services called as Quisenbus Data Services TDS. Then impact analysis, they have Live Compare. They have their own RPA solution called as the RPA Studio. Then they have their own analytics, which will ensure that you are able to analyze your test results and see where are the bugs getting concentrated and all those bigger aspects. Then again, right now for model-based testing, 30 plus technology package apps. So this can be any of the package solutions, Salesforce, SAP, Microsoft later, Oracle later today. Okay. Whatever package apps you can think about, there is an accelerator package from Quisenbus which is readily available. Okay. Another issue which we talked about is availability of all the systems. Okay, for the testing aspect. So if you need to ensure that the availability of all, maybe there might be third-party systems also. So in those aspects, virtualization will come into picture. Okay, you may have to virtualize a service to ensure that at least it is able to mock the response of that. Maybe if you consider system A, B, and C, you may have to implement service virtualization for the application B so that A and C can be tested properly. Okay, and so on. So, Quisenbus is trying to package all these particular solutions and provide to us. So this particular image is, I have taken it from their website. So all the data which you are going to see in these particular slides, this has been taken from their official website or the particular documents which has been released by them. Okay. Can we go to the next slide, please? Okay. So how does Tosca work? Okay. So what is going to happen is you are going to have a lot of technologies, whatever you need to interact with. It can be UI, it can be mobile, DB, SAP systems, Java, application, window-based application. Okay. So it can be any of those, or it can be, without the UI interface as well, the APIs, whatever you're talking about. Okay. So what is going to happen is, if you see this, the image section called a system, it can be any of the systems. Okay. So it can be any of those particular systems which you are trying to interact with. So what is going to happen is Toska is going to capture the technical information from these particular components, and this is going to create something called as a model out of that. Okay. So the Toska working is something like you have a system which you need to interact with. You capture the technical properties of that particular system, whatever you need to interact with. You create something called as a okay. So using that particular model and based on the business function, whatever you are trying to automate, you'll be creating a particular test case. Okay. So you have the technical aspects, you have the business flow, you combine these two, and you combine the test data along with this, and you end up with your test case. Okay. So in Toska again, the emphasis is more on the risk-based testing. So if there is a module which is having a high impact, the frequency of usage is very high, and you know the impact is also very high, so that is a very high risk module. Okay. So in Toska there is a section called as requirements, where you can add the particular requirements and add the risk for those particular requirements as well. Okay. So in Toska you capture technical properties, you have the business function, you combine these two to create the business flow, you combine the test data along with this particular set, and you end up with your test case. Okay. Sure. Can we go to the next slide? Sure. So the other aspect which we are talking about is live compare. Okay. So live compare is a AI driven impact analysis tool for your SAP system. Okay. So it analyzes the version that it gets impacted. So it can be a custom module which you have created, the integration, the security, governance. It considers all those particular factors, and it finally just gives you a report which says these are the particular modules which has been impacted or which will get impacted with your system update. Okay. So instead of an analyst, you know, maintaining a particular impact sheet or you know the module list which says okay, if I touch this particular module, these are the particular things which is getting impacted. Instead of doing that, this particular tool is gonna analyze your SAP system, and then it is gonna give you these are the modules which is gonna be impacted the most, or these are the particular modules which will be impacted. So maybe if you see the graphs, which is there. So every component in SAP you call as an object. Okay, it can be any transaction which you are performing, it can be a custom module which you have implemented. All these are objects. Okay. So if you see the graph over there, you know, if you have like you know more than 3,000 objects to test, okay, and with the particular update, you are not sure which are the systems which will be impacted. See, obviously for the regression aspect, it'll try to cover we'll try to ensure maximum coverage, but then there will be some modules where there should be extra care which should be given because of the impact which this is making. Okay. So the you know live compare what they are searching is it will be able to reduce the test scope by 85%. That is a very huge margin when we think about you know deciding the impact of the SAP system. I'm talking about thousands of customized modules, okay, and you know no way of knowing which are the systems which will be impacted when the update hits your system. Okay. So when you look at the numbers, this is a huge margin or a huge you know value addition which live compare is gonna provide. Okay. So just keep that number in mind. It's like 85% test scope reduction. Okay, just keep that particular number in mind. Can we go to the next slide, please? Sure. The next thing which we are going to see right now is another platform from Tricentis called as Tricentis Flood. Okay. So Tricentis Flood is always my favorite because I think for Programmers Week 2019, I had done a separate session just for Tricentis Flood. That was specifically for browser level users, BLU. Okay. So as you know, almost all account fetching tools which are available right now, it may be HPPC, JMeter, Catlink, all these particular factors in something called as protocol level, simulation. Okay. So Tricentis is providing an open source tool also called as Flood Element, which helps you in simulating something or another, browser level user. Okay. So now for the SAP systems, you may have to simulate protocol level as well as browser level users. So Tricenders Flex is providing options for both. It allows you to execute your JMeter script, your Gatling script. Okay. And the first thing which comes to my mind when I talk about Tricenders Flex is the Hotstar use case. So if you are not read about that particular part, I will urge you to just search Tricenders Flex and Hotstar related use case. So where they use the Tricenders Flex and Gatling to simulate millions of users, the millions in user load for their streaming platform called as Kotstra. So that was one of the highlights in the Tricenders user conferences also. And I had attended their presentation with respect to what was the scale of that particular simulation. So Flex is one of the tools which you can use for continuous load testing. So now everything we are trying to shift left, meaning testing will start as early as possible. So continuous load testing is another aspect which will come into picture. Okay. So, I think I have talked enough. Okay. So we will get into the functional testing aspects using Tricenters Tosca. Can we go to the next slide? Yes. So let's see the functional testing. So for this particular demo, I'll be using Tosca version 13.3 patch 2. Okay, that is the latest version of Tosca which is available. And again, this has, for the purpose of this particular demo, I have already created a workspace. Okay, so what we are going to do right now is we are going to make use of the training infrastructure provided by Tricenters for their certification. So we'll be making use of the SaaS system which is available there, and we'll be trying to connect to that and try to perform some sort of functional testing there. Okay, so this is how the Tricenters, Tosca GUI looks like. So in the home tab, if I go to the project node, you can see the different sections which are available in Tosca, like issues, modules, reporting, requirements, test planning. These are different sections which are available in Tosca. Okay, so for this purpose of this demo, we'll be just making use of modules as well as test cases. Okay, so now if I go to the module section, you can see something called a standard module. So standard modules are like built-in modules which are provided by Tosca. Okay, so for example, if I expand HTML, there might be different modules available for maybe like opening URL, maybe opening a SAP Theory interface, NetWeaver, maybe click close a browser, connect to Chrome or Chromium. Okay, so these are some of like built-in modules. Okay, so here if you see, there is a built-in module for SAP as well. So here you can see modules like SAP login, where you can provide details of like user password, logon, where you can provide the path, the SAP connection string, SAP menu bar to navigate through the menu bar. Then status bar, like there will be success messages which is provided in the status bar, how to pull that. Maybe in the toolbar, there will be sections where you can enter the transaction code. Okay, so everything in SAP can be triggered through a transaction code, and a very skilled user, he will be just entering the transaction code and he'll be just pressing enter, control S. I mean, there might be shortcuts available within the SAP system. Okay, so in the SAP toolbar, as you saw, there are different n number of options which are readily available. In menu part, what will be the three entry structure which is available. All these particular modules are readily available for us. Okay, so this is gonna have a huge impact on how much time we are spending on accessing the particular system or setting up the initial environment and so on. Okay, so for this purpose of this demo, we'll be connecting to the SAP server, which is provided by Tricenters for the training purposes. So this LMS is the user ID which we'll be making use of. And the password is obviously changed after the first login. So we are logging into the SAP system. And again, here if you see, this is a ECC 6.0 system. This belongs to the older version. I didn't have the infra for HANA system right now. Okay. So here what we are going to see is in order to cache process, there's a process called VA01 and VN0LN. So we'll be interacting with both of those particular processes. Okay. So the first one is the sales order. So what we are going to do is we'll just quickly open it up and see like what are the different UI components which are available and which are the fields which are available. So we have an order type, organization, division, and so on. So we'll just quickly see like what are the order types which are available. Okay. So in the order type, you'll have to enter this particular code, which you can see in the right hand side. So if we need to perform a cache raid, you'll have to enter CS in the order type. And accordingly, you need to fill the other data. Okay. So depending on what sort of transaction you are trying to perform or what sort of sales order you are trying to create in the particular system, you'll have to enter the corresponding order type there. Okay. So I've just clicked on that just so that you will get to know like what are the different things available in that. So let me go back. Again, similar thing for both of these particular systems. So once you create a sales order, there will be an outbound delivery order also. So depending on the shopping point, different aspects will come into picture. So again, depending on what sort of outbound order you are trying to make, you'll need to choose the particular transaction code. Here's the shopping point code. So what we are going to do right now is we are going to try and I'm going to quickly show you like how we will be creating a particular button. And then we'll quickly see how we are going to what usually happens when you try to automate something. Okay. So I'm just going to quickly create a module which captures the technical property of the system. So I'm going to create a technical module for sales order. So now I'm going to send the application. While scanning the section which is opening up right now is something called as XScan. So what is going to happen is I'm going to choose the application which I'll need to scan. And the XScan is going to give me an option to choose the controls which I need to interact with. Okay. So what I'm going to do right now is I have an option to choose the control. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on the component which I need. And I'm just going to click on save. So that will create the module for us. And if I need to, need to create a test case out of this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag and drop this particular, module to the test case section. Okay. Ideal case, I'll be creating folders, subfolders, and then I'll be providing the whatever be the data which I need to enter for these particular aspects. And here you can see the various action modes which are available, like input, verify, buffer, reach on. Okay. So verify is if you need to similar to your assertion, which are available. So right now I already have created the particular test case. So we'll just quickly see what are the process which has been done. So I've given the path of the SAP logon server, as well as SAP connection name, as well as user ID password. And we'll just quickly see, what is happening. So let me navigate back to the home screen. Okay. So we are trying to open VA01. Okay. So here at the top, you can see a section where you can enter the transaction code. So at the input text box there, if I enter VA01 and if I press enter, you can see that I have been taken to the sales order. Okay. And I'll be pressing enter. So that takes me to the sales order page. In the sales order, I'll be choosing OR 1000, 1200 and so on to create the sales order. Once the data is entered,
So depending on the system which you are working with, the you know parameters which you need to enter will differ. So I am simulating pressing enter. Okay, so it will be taking me here. So here I need to mention the PO number, the solid two party as well as solid from party. Okay, so here I'll be adding the details with respect to you know which is a product which I want to create an order for and other details. So we'll quickly get into that. So once that is done, I need to press enter. The next step which has been mentioned is press enter again. In the table, I need to mention the item number, the material, and the order quantity. Okay. So in the table, I will be entering the data. So I need to enter 2 M08. So this is just a functional scenario which I am trying to simulate for you guys. The order quantity will be something like 5. And the product code will be something like XP. And I can just press enter. So once I do that, I can see that the you know ID details, the code details for that particular product, all those things has been fetched from the DB and it has been added. Okay. So now in the SAP menu, I need to click on go to header and sales. So if you see the various options which are available at the toolbar level, you can see that those are not the you know particular section we were looking at. So here you can see like widget document, create a new document, and underneath you can see options or like you know delete item, delete entry which is there in that particular item, and so on. Okay. So now what we are gonna do is at the top, along with edit, settings, help, and other things, you can see a option there called as go to. Okay, so if I go to header and then sales, all this particular data, whatever has been entered, is now there on the sales screen. Okay, now once I have done with that, the other thing which I need to add is I need to change the document date. So here you can see the document date which is getting highlighted. So, and again, for the document date, it has been auto-populated. I have used something called as a date function within Tosca so that it will auto-generate a date the very next day. So this was recorded on 16, I mean yesterday night. So what is going to happen is it is going to auto-generate a date like 17/9/2020. So once that is done, I'll be pressing on save. Okay, the save icon at the top. So in the status bar, I should be getting a success message. Okay, standard order followed by a number has been saved. Okay. So now once you have placed the order, the major part, I mean, it will be depending on the order number only, I'll be able to perform some other transaction in some other system. Okay. So what is going to happen here is that module, once it is, once that order number is there, that is a dynamic date. Okay, once you submit the form, everything else is done. It is a dynamic data. And again, if you see, we already have a built-in module called as SAP status bar. Okay, which will help me in fetching the message as well as the message type. I can validate those things. Okay, so in the value section, if you see, I have used something called as a X buffer. Okay. So what is going to happen here is, I mean, the dynamic buffer, which is going to happen is, whenever I mention XB, okay, it will consider that as a dynamic data and it will store it in that variable called as order number. See the message which is delivered, it will be something like standard order followed by some particular number. Okay. And then followed by some text. Okay, so that particular string which I have provided in the message is standard order, XB order, then star, meaning anything after that. Okay, after status order, whatever text comes, it will be stored in that particular variable called as order number. Okay, so once that is done, I'll be pressing slash n and I'll be closing the particular transaction. Okay. So this is something which, you know, happens in almost all the particular transactions. You enter a transaction code or a T code, you go to the particular module, you enter whatever data, I mean, you create the particular order by entering whatever data is required. And now, again, in SAP toolbar, I already have an option to enter the transaction code and press enter. Okay. So at the top, what I'm going to do is, we already know the input text box where we can enter the transaction code. Okay. So there is a transaction code which you need to enter is slash n. Okay. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to press, I mean, type slash n and I'm going to press enter, which will take me back to the home page. Okay. Now again, I can enter another transaction code. It will take another process. Okay. And I can, using this particular order number, I'll be continuing with the particular process. Okay. So if you look at this from a functional setting aspect, in all this, if I'm automating two of the particular process in this scenario, what I want to highlight here is I have only created, two such modules. Two modules which is dependent on my ERP implementation. Rest of the common things which is available in the SAP GUI is available, and I'm just making use of those particular modules to interact with the particular system. Okay. So don't worry about the prompt which is coming up. That is because I need to add the price and this process to the security settings of SAP. That has not happened while I was recording this particular video. So that's why that prompt is coming up. So here you can see that the user ID and password is getting entered, and I am getting navigated to the SAP system. So now it will be entering the data for all these particular processes. And once it enters all the particular data, you can see that the data is getting populated in the table. It's the same business flow which we saw earlier. It will be changing the document date. I'll be clicking on save. So I'll be taking the order number and other things. I'm going to the outbound delivery option. And I'm entering the particular data there. So here you can see this data is already populated. I'm saving the data. And that's done with the creation of the outbound order. Okay. So if you take a look at this particular entire process which has been implemented, the custom function which I had to create for the custom modules which is there in my system is maybe two. Rest of the common interactions that are readily available in the system, I'm making use of the standard module. Okay. So here you can see that the standard order and followed by the number, okay, has been used, and it has been stored in that particular local variable as well. Okay. And in the other case also, we had another XP which was used in one of the transactions. That is also being shown there. With respect to the other sections which are available, like requirements, test case design, issues where you can raise the bugs and other things, the planning section where you can have time boxed exploratory testing sessions if you have multiple exploratory testers who are exploring the system and other things, you can plan that particular session here. Okay, it is time boxed exploratory session. Okay, so because of the short duration which we are having, we cannot get into all the details of all the sections. And again, this execution I have done is via Scratchbook. So Scratchbook is used for just debugging your test. You just need to execute and see whether it works or something like that. We'll be making use of Scratchbook. Okay. Otherwise, we'll need to make use of the execution list. Okay. So yeah. So just wanted to showcase like how easier it will be when it comes to a functional testing aspect of the SAP system. Okay, so let's get back to the presentation. And yeah, so one of the things which I wanted to highlight as I wanted to add a use case also. sorry. Yeah. So I wanted to add a use case also for this particular presentation. And one of the highlighted use cases from TriCenter is the S4 implementation for Vodafone. Okay. Vodafone is one of the largest telecom providers in Europe. Okay. So for the case study which has been shared by them with respect to the challenges which they have faced when they are trying to try to work with multiple systems which are integrated. Okay, there might be a SAP GUI interface, there might be integrations with n number of third party cloud vendors and other things. Okay, so they have showcased the intensity and complexity of the system when you are a global conglomerate. So the one of the highlights which I want to bring forth here is can we click on the next slide? One of the key things which I want to highlight is the implementation what had happened. So they were able to achieve 81% of end-to-end test automation coverage, 200% faster test automation implementation, and the claim is 440 days of working time has been saved within a year. Okay. So from the different articles which I had gone through, they had implemented this in over 10 months time period. Okay, the 81% test automation coverage, for SAP, web, mobile, API. And the implementation results, which speaks a lot, is like 70% test automation across S/4HANA. Okay, integration with CI/CD for immediate feedback, full replacement of HP Micro, Focus UFT, migrated almost 10,000 UFT tests to model based tests. Okay, and one of the key highlights here is, the vendors are still, almost all the tool vendors, they are still struggling to, accommodate the, theory related changes or UI related changes for SAP system. And that's when this particular partnership has popped up, and you can find the solutions which is which we have talked about, like Tosca, Live Compare, load testing using Flood.io in the SAP ALM marketplace. Okay, the name might be slightly different, like TriCenter's continuous testing platform and so on, but these particular solutions, whatever we talked about, you will be able to find them in the SAP marketplace. Okay. Yeah. Can we go to the next slide, please? Okay. So these were the references which I had made use of while creating this particular deck. So, I will urge you guys to go through the, case study document, especially just to, understand the depth as well as the impact with these particular tools that are making for, known IT challenges. Okay. So that is something which I will urge all of you guys to, go through once. Can we go to the next slide, please? I think I am done with my presentation aspects, and I'm open to questions if you guys have any. And again, if you guys have any questions, I think you will be able to send out an email to the Programmers Week email ID, and we will try to address those particular questions as soon as possible. So if you guys have any questions, I can address them. Okay, sure. Okay. So any other automation tools available for SAP S/4HANA? Yes, other software tool vendors are also raising up to that. So now, when I was reading before this particular session, there are solutions from SmartBS. They have the built-in collaboration with almost all the tool vendors. But then now, even this much of integration for all the various aspects, like UI, the functional aspect, the performance aspect, as well as the impact aspect, not been achieved by any other vendor. As far as whatever information I could gather, no other vendor has been able to support in all these three various aspects. But then functional testing, yes, they have been able to, because finally, any vendor who is able to customize their offering, they will be able to address the challenges with respect to the UI aspect. But then no other vendor has been able to address all the three aspects, functional, performance, as well as the impact part when it comes to the migration of SAP system or updates of SAP. I hope it answered your question. Yes, in that particular aspect, yes, the Sitecenter is trying to make that particular impact. Okay, any other questions? Thank you, Melvin.